ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృత దుఃఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పెరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 23 ఆఫ్ 7th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ వాచం అంతవత్తు ఫలం తేషాం తద్భవత్యల్పమేధసాం దేవాన్ దేవయజో యాంతి మద్భక్తా యాంతి మామపి. ఫాస్ట్ ఫ్యూ శ్లోకస్ భగవాన్ కృష్ణ ఇస్ గివింగ్ ద డీటెయిల్డ్ ది యాటిట్యూడ్ అండ్ నేచర్ దాట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి ఇంప్లైడ్ ఇన్ అ డివోటీస్ మైండ్. అ డివోషన్ భక్తి మీన్స్ ఇట్స్ అ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్. The transaction, it differs according to the maturity level of a devotee. As we saw, a devotee is a transaction alone, but the transaction has to have surrendering and shraddha. So the devotee should be loaded with lots of shraddha and surrendering. Then the transaction will work because it's a kind of unique self transaction. So when he goes to Venkateswara, in front of Venkateswara, so Venkateswara is welcoming all the people, but we have to open up. And many people, so in the preliminary stage, in the beginning stage, when you said the devotion, a bhakti, so which is in the form of asking something, nothing but the transaction. So when you ask something, so there are some people, we need not to ask anything from the God. They conclude, but jnanis, they don't ask anything from the God because there is nothing to ask. But these people who say that God knows about us, He knows what I need, therefore I am not going to ask because it's a confusion. It's a confusion or it can be the laziness. Not able to think what he wants, not able to conclude what he wants. So he doesn't have a clear-cut vision about his life. That lacking should not be there. When there is a transaction, that first transaction, it is sakama bhakti, means what? Desire-oriented bhakti means you should have the plan first. Then you have to execute with the plan to the deity. Doesn't matter what deity that you worship, Lord Venkateswara, good, and Rajarajeshwari, good, Lord Shiva, very good, and Lord Sriranga, very, very good, but every god is Lord Venkateswara. That is the devotee of Venkateswara should have the confidence. Now the transaction, it begins from you, which is in the form of plan. You should ask. If you want to set the sakama bhakti, you should ask, you should plan, and you should conclude what you need. When you have made the decision, then alone you can ask something. The life is to live with the plan. So devotee means it's not like that you can live without any plan. You should have the plan. A devotion is a pure transaction with the Ishwara. And you get whatever you want because He is the creator. He is none other than the sustainer. Or we can say preserver. He is the preserver of the universe because being in the universe itself, so He is protecting everybody. That's what we elaborately saw by the category of para and apara prakriti. Now the devotee who is in the beginning stage, he should ask, he will get everything while receiving whatever desired which was requested. He should be thankful, he should set the prasada buddhi. But Krishna also does one more thing in this verse. It's a kind of, you know, statutory warning to the devotees, because devotee has surrendered and he has said the Shraddha. Now there is a duty for Bhagavan to warn him, don't be with limited happiness, my dear. So this is like when you have the cigarette pack. That cigarette pack, so the brand of that cigarette, it's in bold letter, but in the small letters, cigarette smoking injurious to health. So we only go for the bold letters. Bhagavan says, I will give whatever you need, I will give. God has two pockets. His hands are inset in two pockets. One pocket is called finite fruits, means limited fruits. Another for moksha, infinite fruits. Now, so when devotee goes in front of the God, he always asks for this limited fruit. I need to have job, I need to have longevity, I need to have house, I need to have relative, I need to get married, I need to get children, I need to have insurance. So all these things are absolutely finite in the nature. Doesn't matter, God doesn't blame it. You can ask whatever you want, but you will get if you set a proper devotion, bhakti towards me, I will provide. Therefore, so one pocket and one hand is always busy, that hand which gives finite result, the another pocket is very relaxed, nobody asks. There Bhagavan says, my dear, the materials of the world has got defects, doshamantaha. And we can also classify in three variety of defects. Those three varieties, so one by one we will see. The first is, so every material is endowed with mishritatvam, dukkha mishritatvam. Whatever you ask, Bhagavan is ready to give. Once you achieve it, you can feel there is also the painful experience. No object, no enjoyment which contains 100% joyfulness, enjoyment means happiness. They have certain pain. So you get a new house. In the new house, you are very happy, but slowly you could see that expenditures of the house, it started eating you. Or some kind of a rivalry, enemies, neighbors, you get something will be there. Pleasure and pain, they are both sides of a coin. Therefore, they are dukkha mishritatva. They are endowed with, it's a mixture of pain and pleasure. This is one defect with all the object, all kinds of, even swarga loka, so you should come back. There is a tharatamya. The category wise, there is also grades. According to every individual grade, you will get. And the next defect is atriptikaratvam. Atriptikaratvam means it doesn't contain a complete satisfaction. Once you get what you need, you should be happy. But mind will set, you know, for the higher properties. It will go beyond that. Once you get, you should be satisfied with that entity which you get. But no, mine will compare with others. What he has. My elder brother, he had. Even they compare after 10 years. So elder brother had completed 12th standard 8 years ago. The younger one, the last one, is finishing the plus 2 or 10th now. So elder brother had got first in the state. Now this younger, he has become second in the state. He got, you know, he got all honored. Then the jealous. The elder brother become jealous with the younger one. Why? There is no reason. The achievements it won't allow you to be with complete satisfaction. Some reason it will continue with dissatisfaction. See, dukkha, the continuing with the pain, but continuing with the dissatisfaction, there is a slight difference. This is also a defect of all the worldly materials. Then the third one. So when we say it's bandhakatvam, they have a tendency to bind with those natures. Now after the tiredness, so a person who was in the big position in the society, so he has to retire after 60 years. So when he becomes 60 year old, he has to get away from that. Once he got retired, the next day, my God, people after retirement, you know, their mind becomes something abnormal. Every people, so some of them are very positive, you know, they include or they adapt some other job, immediately they jump from here to there. But if the people are little bit careless, my God, they have to undergo so many ups and downs in their mind. The position is lost. Now, again, you know, the mind will be longing to get that. That is the problem in the politician's life. So once the power is gone, they feel nothing because they want to experience their existence in that. The human being, you know, they have their defects. When you go to your own relative's marriage, in the entrance, you need to be invited, welcomed with a proper smiling face. They should, yes, yes, welcome, welcome, welcome. That's what you expect. If nobody is welcoming you, if nobody is looking at you, then what happens, you know, the whole time when you spend in that marriage, you will be looking for you. That's what mind language. So you lost yourself if somebody comes after an hour and asks, you know, when did you come? Wah, 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 wah. So I have, you know, I'm very thankful to you. Then you will get you. My God, I got myself. That's what the human tendency. It's a deficiency. It's a defect of us. Therefore, you have to be very careful with the mind, because mind also is a finite product. Therefore, the finite and finite is equal to finite alone. They cannot become or they cannot bring infinite fruits or joy or enjoyment. They cannot. Therefore, these three defects are known as limited. One word, antavat tu phalam tesham, tesham bhaktanam. So these people, devotees, who pray for this limited fruit, they will continue with the limited samsara. Limited samsara means they cannot get complete satisfaction. Therefore what? Their mind, which is lacking of viveka. Unintelligent people, alpamedhasam. Now you see, if you want to become a devotee, you have to be intelligent devotee. God himself says those people are unintelligent people because they are not aware how to transact with the God, because God, who is none other than the creator of the world, he could give what? He could give world and he could give himself. Devan devayajaha yanti, devayajaha, seeking for small deities, worshipping small deities, it won't help them to get eternity. So people who become very clear about me, asking God is the big transaction. That has to be with a proper devotee. Madbhaktaha mam apiyanti. They definitely get me when they ask for me.
it becomes my duty to give myself to them. Myself to them means I have to raise them to equal of my consciousness level. That's what the confirmation, which is in the form of statement of Lord Krishna in the verse 23. Next verse, avyaktam vyaktimapannam manyante mama buddhayah param bhavam janantah mama vyayaman uttamam. Now God wants to say, when I myself speak to the devotee, they should understand, you know, the value of the things which I say. So when Lord Krishna, in his contemporary, not all people accepted his the incarnation of the Ishvara. They are confused. There was one person called Shishupalaha. He was not accepting the God, means Krishna, as the God. He was struggling with that belief. Shraddha won't come. Even now, your mind is informed in so many things. I always say, you know, when you are able to believe, you are gifted. Even people who doesn't believe God, but they believe in so many things. In cricket, there are superstitions. The position they sit, if they change the position, so once they cross the leg, the sixer comes, immediately all other people will say that you sit in the same way. Even while watching TV, means not directly watching the crickets. From the house, 10 people are watching the cricket. One person who went to bathroom and who was in the bathroom, so now they got 3 sixers. When he comes out, there is a wicket gone. Then all other people ask him to stay in the bathroom itself. It happened. But in that place, nobody will say that that is a blind faith. It's a superstition. What is the attitude which we have? The superstition. What is the relationship, connection with the batsman, with the bowler, and with the fellow who is in the bathroom? What is the mind? You know, that's the tendency of the mind, weakness of the mind. But when Bhagavan says, so he says, nothing but the fact you cannot deny. So you have to know how to assimilate it. That's your part. You can say that I'm not able to believe. That is the statement one should have or one can have. He should not say that I don't believe God. He should say I'm not able to believe God. That has to be the statement. You are not able to believe God means you are not given time to prepare yourself. Or you can say that I'm not able to believe, but I will study what exactly the God is. And not coming for the studies and not willing to even understand anything about God. The word Ishvara, the word Bhagavan, all the names of the deities given in Vedas, Vigneshwaraha and Parameshwaraha, and even all individual deities' name means it can be Sri Ranganatha, Venkateswara, Parthasarathi, Vasudeva, and Trivikrama, Vamadeva. So all these names are from Vedas. If you want to know the meaning of these words, you have to study thoroughly Veda. You cannot deny, you need not to deny. Even Bhagavan also says, when you realize God, at that time also, you have to be very careful with your mind. You can understand or accept certain things, you cannot accept certain things. And people say that, yes, we accept God, but we cannot accept Krishna as God. Why? What happened? Krishna says, you yourself is nothing but God. Why can't you accept him as a God? No, he was born as a blood and flesh. So what? Now, see, blood and flesh, and he was also killed by somebody. You know, some hunter killed him. That's what I heard. Did you see? Krishna himself said, whatever is born, it has to be gone. But whatever that upadesha, the teaching which he impart for the human society, you have to realize it. When you realize that, definitely you can enjoy the God concept in you. That's what he says, avyaktam vyaktim apannam mam manyate abuddhayaha. These unintelligent people, they are struggling with their acceptance. That's not my problem, that's their problem. So not even thinking to set the bhakti, but they will comment on the bhakti. Because all these people are blind faith people. You go to Lord Shiva's temple or Vaishnava's temple. So this Tripundra and this the Chinna, which way they call it Bhasma, when they wear, they feel that godliness. You don't have the rights to comment on it, because if you don't know what for it is done, you should not open your mouth. Those all, you know, all attiring, and they have their own lifestyle. If you don't have the capacity to make devotion in your life, you don't have the rights to comment on a devotee, on a devotion. That has to be understood. Even Krishna says, so there are people who think that I am born as a human being. So once I am born, they think that I am not the God, I am the human being. Param bhavam ajanantaha mama avyayam anuttamam param bhavam ajanantaha, not knowing my supreme level of consciousness, which is nothing but the glorious one. But they comment on, they think that I am also a normal human being. But this statement Bhagavan brings here for normal people, the people with the devotion, people without devotion. Abhaktaha and bhaktaha. So abhakta means what? He is struggling with his acceptance. There is no life without belief. In the beginning itself, I have told. If there is no belief, if you are not able to construct a belief system on you, on your work, on others, then you cannot lead your life successfully, even it is in the materialistic aspects. That's what Bhagavan says. They struggle. These abhaktas, they struggle. They have their own problem. Therefore, what? They will start commenting on others. Always these bhaktas are commented upon. But bhakta, they never worry about it. For them, everything is Ishvara. They take the comment as the complimentary. Because for them, it is a sadhana. It's a sadhana. When you comment on them, they'll become more stronger. More powerful followers of devotion, bhakti marga. Now, Bhagavan gives lots of respect to the devotees, because a devotee alone can become jnani. The devotion, it transforms up to the level of jnani bhakti. That's what he continues. That we will continue from the next episode tomorrow. Hari Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harih Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harih Om.